The meta-changing Season 12 update, in addition to the changes to the Olympus map, has left us with a lot of new things to discover, and as such I thought I'd drop a few tips to give you an edge in the new Apex Legends season. So without further ado, here's 23 tips for Apex Legends in Season 12. You ready? Let's go! The new point of interest called Face Driver drops high tier loot comparable to the loot that you can find in the Fight Night ring. By pressing this button, you will spawn a few loot ticks that drop around the Face Driver. Keep in mind though that this is very loud and it will attract enemies. These Marvin robots that you can find scattered all over Olympus are key to gearing up with high tier loot. By interacting with them, you will get free items of either white, blue, or purple variety. You can actually guarantee to always get level 3 items if you press the interact key right when a white smiley face has left the screen and the blue one is about to appear. If the Marvin has sparks coming out of it, you can actually break it and it will drop a Marvin arm. After picking one up, you'll get a prompt to ping the nearest Marvin. Doing this will ping a Marvin location on your map, and if you go there and interact with that robot, the arm will attach to them, and they will gratefully gift you free legendary items. Heads up, you can still get the arm after you've gotten the loot, so you should be able to, double dip. These Face Driver portals are a great way to quickly get around the map, but because of their central location, odds are that you're gonna find yourself in over your head at times. If you happen to get knocked near the portals in this location, you can't really take the portal to escape because of this small ledge blocking your way, unless you crawl around to this lip right here and then make your way over. In previous Apex seasons, Olympus used to have a guaranteed legendary items drop in this specific area by the Hammond Labs waterfall. This has now been nerfed and relocated to a different set of loot bins on the map, namely these three, all the way north of the docks. It seems that it's not as potent as the waterfall location, but I'm curious to hear what results you guys have gotten out of it. The POI Icarus has a bridge which features loot very reminiscing of the loot vaults on World's Edge. The keycard to enter the bridge is found on one of these dead scientists scattered throughout the ship. The ability to punch boost, which would absolutely launch you down a slope, has been hard nerfed this season, but it's still possible to do so in order to hit maximum slide velocity. It works a little bit different though. To do this, you have to jump and crouch, turn around midair, and punch so that your punch connects with the slope underneath you the second you land. This only works on some slopes, but it has some niche uses. Maggie's riot drill can be stuck to doors. The flames will break through and slowly break the door and hurt you if you're on the other side. If you are blocking a door that gets stuck by the drill, be careful how you move out of the way, because Maggie can open that door or shoot it open and the flame will swing right in your direction. As of Season 12, caustic traps can now be destroyed after they have been triggered. They will still break instantly when shot on the bottom before they trigger, but once they emit gas, they will have 150 HP. If a crypto EMPs these barrels, the EMP does 100 damage per barrel. Maggie's ultimate, Wrecking Ball, leaves a trail of blue dots that linger on the ground for about 82 seconds. These blue dots increase your movement speed by 30%, but also briefly lock you in the direction that you were already heading, giving you a lot less fluidity in your movement, and you might actually get stuck if you're trying to run and slide at the same time. Skynading is utilized in high ranked and in professional play, but rarely seen outside of those lobbies. The act of skynading means that you throw a grenade straight up into the air and it will blow up almost instantly when it lands. This is also highly efficient if you want to grenade out someone who has the high ground on you. You can actually also arc the grenade to instantly blow up in ranges all the way up to 50 meters ahead of you. When holding a grenade, line up the visible arc to your hand. The tip of the thumb will make the grenade blow up at 10 meters ahead of you, the top of the knuckles will blow it up at 20 meters, bottom of the knuckle 30 meters, the base of your finger is 40 meters, and the base of the hand is about 50 meters in front of you. You can actually get kill points on enemies that other players have knocked. You get awarded the kill point if the player who knocked him in the first place is no longer in the game, either by dying and going back to the lobby or just leaving the game. This means that if you do a third party and you wipe out one of the teams, start with finishing the knocks to get the free kill points. You can fully repair your shield just by putting it in the replicator. Not only does this replenish your shield, but it also upgrades it by 150 damage. Just make sure that you don't do this when enemies are nearby, as the replicator leaves you without a shield for the duration of the craft. If your gun is empty and needs to be reloaded, it's actually faster to swap to a fresh gun than to actually reload. You can take this either from the ground or from a box. This is also faster than reloading after a fight and then filling up your ammo afterward. If you find yourself in the unfortunate situation of not having any ammo in your gun or in your inventory, swapping to fresh guns that you find on the ground will allow you to at least have a small reserve of ammunition with you. When fighting a full team, make sure that you're only exposed to one enemy at a time. If the enemy team starts focusing and pushing you, try to pull back and find a new angle where you're once again only dealing with one enemy at a time. In addition to this, try to only expose a small part of yourself. When playing around cover, you want to try and keep about 2/3 of your screen behind cover for optimal safety. Every team fight has a small brief window of downtime. These small windows should be used to top yourself up with something like a syringe, cell, or battery. You always want to try and heal up when you are missing health, and make use of these tiny windows to make sure that you're always at 100% effectiveness. Many players just stand around behind cover doing absolutely nothing and instead waiting during teamfights, and being proactive will easily turn the fight in your favor. Building on that last tip, also make sure that your guns are always reloaded. Reloading doesn't take nearly as much time to do as healing, and you will usually have time to reload the second you or your enemy enters cover. I very rarely let my magazines empty out fully unless I am mag dumping into an enemy. Also, reloading with ammo still in a gun reduces load time significantly, as you don't need to cock the gun at the end of the animation. This is a big one. Play to stay alive. This is different for every player, but just try to stay alive no matter what. Don't overextend or ego peek. Instead, try and play cover and stay close to your teammates. If you take too much heat and damage, try to pull back before they manage to get a knock on you. If your teammates properly cover you, or if you manage to get behind them, you can reset and get back into the fight. This is especially valuable because the risk of a third party is always super high. And if you get knocked, you will not survive a third party. This doesn't mean that you have to go back and full heal if you take damage. Sometimes the best play is simply retreating behind your teammates and pushing with them. For example, if you made a favorable trade, dealing more damage on the enemies than they did on you. If that happens, you want to let your team move forward and play behind them, using them as a body shield. The enemy team shouldn't be shooting at you because they're too busy shooting at your teammates. And you can do hell of a lot more damage than if you were hiding in a bush and batting up. Armor swapping is one of the most undervalued skills in the game, so I'm just gonna keep stressing it. These allow you to quickly switch out your armor and get back into the fight, saving you over 10 seconds from healing up. This can be coupled with the last tip, where you can quickly swap your armor from a broken red armor to, hell, even a white off of a random box, and join your team and quickly apply pressure, but with a little bit of a safety net. If you want to learn more about armor swapping and just looting fast in general, I made a guide on this and it's available on the screen right now. I've also dropped it in the description. You can also take armors and pull them out of boxes to place them in your line of sight but behind cover preemptively. A common use of this tactic is when your teammate gets knocked and you finish a fight, quickly grabbing an armor or two and placing them next to your resting and your downed teammate as they are recovering will allow them to grab the armors when finished and let your team reset to full health a little bit faster. This next tip is from old source games such as Counter-Strike that doesn't have climbing, and it works just as well in Apex Legends because it's built on a Titanfall code, which in turn is built on the Source engine. When you're healing up, you will not be able to scale any obstacles, meaning that there's a certain height that you cannot clear until you've popped your heal. This can be circumvented by jumping and crouching at the same time. But you can also take this to the next level by standing next to the ledge of your choice, looking about 90 degrees away, and then swinging your view towards the ledge while crouch jumping. Many legends can lock doors with their abilities. Ashe can use her tactical or portal to stop someone from entering a room. Caustic obviously is trapper ultimate. Fuse his tactical ultimate. Horizon can actually place her tactical inside of a doorframe or right in front of it. Lifeline can permanently block certain doors with her ultimate. Loba can block a door with her ultimate. Octane's jump pad can make it impossible to run in. Rampart Waltz. Revenant can obscure the view and make it unsafe to cross through the door. Obviously Watson's fences. And finally, Wraith can completely lock two doorways by placing her portals between them, making running through them an unsavory choice. And those are all 20 free tips for Apex Legends Season 12. If you enjoyed the video, make sure that you did hit that like button and subscribe so you don't miss more content. If you want to see me using these tips when I tried Imperial Health Sensitivity for 24 hours, that video is on the screen right now. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you all tomorrow.